given by one student. As you know, there are certain conditions, and on those conditions, farmers decide which crop should be cultivated in which type of field. There are a series of physical factors and series of the human factors. They influence the locational factor. Further, one funnel gave the role of the market for the localization of the different type of agricultural activity. One funnel like presumed some of the conditions that they are found everywhere equitable. So this is very idealistic model. And though it was published in, it was written in 1826, but further translated in 1960s, and after 75 years, it became popular only after that. So yesterday we discussed what is the role of the distance of the agricultural locational farmlands from the market, how the distance from the market influenced the locational pattern of the agriculture. Simultaneously, if I explain in the other words, like yesterday I gave you one model, so this is one model, say model A. Model A is like this is the cost of production. So production, this is the distance. Distance from the city, and say this is 20 kilometer. So this is the cost. Cost of production. So any agricultural cost of production for every crop according to one to the preconditions, all crops are, the cost is same everywhere, whether we grow the crop very close to the city or we grow crop to the 20 kilometer from the city. But what varies, it increases the distance. Distance increases the cost of production. Cost of production increases when we move away, because this is the transport cost. Transport cost increases because beyond this certain limit, profit is zero. Zero profit. And beyond this, if the profit decreases, so here this is the total profit. This is the production cost and this is the profit. But when we increase the distance, maximum our profit becomes zero. Yahan karenge to profit would be near the city, profit is higher. Here profit is half and here profit is zero. It means when we go away from the city, but in the another model, say model B, let me try to explain with the model B how one student try to simplify the production price. Yesterday we constructed one table how the distance increases the transport cost. That was one example I gave you, the potato. Suppose there are the different crops. Say crop like vegetables are there. If we grow say milk, if we grow grains or the food grains, or that was the time period when we were one student was more in 1826, most of the requirement of the people for energy are met by the wood. There was limited or no supply of coal, limited supply of coal. Sab lakdi par nirbhar tha. So wood was, production of wood was another. Wood means fuel wood. Fuel wood was one of the important. So in this model B, one student try to simplify the LR. LR means economic rent or the land rent. I would say land rent. or you can say in other words, we can say profit. Profit is like this, it increases higher the profit. Say this is the city and this is the distance. Distance and far off, say this is 20 kilometer. So I am just taking it. So this is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, or the 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, or this is 16, 14, 16, like these are the kilometers. Yesterday we constructed the graph of the potato, how with the increasing distance economic rent decreases. Sometimes if I make the vegetables, when we grow the vegetables, the profit of vegetable decreases rapidly. अगर वेजिटेबल्स को सिटी के नजदीक ग्रो करेंगे तो उसका प्रॉफिट इतना होगा. इफ वी ग्रो द वेजिटेबल्स विद इंक्रीजिंग डिस्टेंस, 4 किलोमीटर से ज्यादा बढ़ते ही उसके ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट बढ़ जाएगी. बिकॉज वेजिटेबल्स आर द आइटम्स विच रिक्वायर रेगुलर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, दे आर द पेरिसेबल, दे शुड बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड इमीडिएटली. सो सिटी से दूर जाते हैं तो उनका कॉस्ट बढ़ जाता है, बट near the city their profit margin is highest. So this is called vegetables. I would say vegetables. Say for production of the milk, milk production में हम ऐसा कर सकते हैं, it is sometimes जो हमने कल tabulation की उसके base पे, this is one hypothetical. Suppose this is for the milk. Milk production, it is like this. यहाँ यहाँ grow करेंगे तो milk यहाँ इतना profit आएगा, यहां ग्रो करेंगे तो इतना, और इसके बाद ग्रो करेंगे तो मिल्क का प्रॉफिट जीरो हो जाएगा, माइनस पे जाएगा. सो नो फार्मर विल प्रेफर टू गो वाइट बियॉन्ड दिस. देन ग्रेन्स या से फ्यूल और द वेजिटेबल, सॉरी हॉर्टिकल्चरल क्रॉप्स. हॉर्टिकल्चरल क्रॉप्स आर गुड इफ वी ग्रो लाइक दिस. दिस इज गुड फॉर हॉर्टिकल्चरल क्रॉप्स. और इफ वी ग्रो से लाइफ स्टॉक फॉर मीट, मीट पर्पज, और द मीट पर्पज, तो हम उसके लिए मीट के लिए अगर लाइफ स्टॉक करेंगे तो हमारा प्रॉफिट ऐसे, यहां से नियर द सिटी इट इज लाइक दिस, फॉर इट बट इट कैन बी रियर्ड बियॉन्ड दिस लिमिट. एंड अगर हम ग्रेन पैदा करें तो उसमें ग्रेन्स के लिए हो सकता है ये यहीं तक जाए. से मैंने ये क्या लिखा, ये मिल्क के लिए लिखा, ये मीट के लिए लिखा है एनिमल्स को, और ये मैंने ग्रेन्स के लिए लिखा. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द एंटायर, बिकॉज आई टोल्ड यू वॉन थुनन वाज ए गुड अकाउंटेंट, ही कीप ईच एंड एवरी रिकॉर्ड ऑफ हिज प्रोडक्ट एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड आउटपुट. जितना इनकम होता था वो लिखता था, उसके बेस पे उन्होंने डेवलप किया. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस वेयर इज द हाईएस्ट इकोनॉमिक रेंट, हमने 5 क्रॉप आपको बताई, इसमें सबसे ज्यादा इकोनॉमिक रेंट सिटी के पास किसका है, वेजिटेबल्स. एंड वेजिटेबल का कहां तक है, इस डिस्टेंस तक. इसके बाद किसका प्रॉफिट ज्यादा है, इसके बाद प्रॉफिट मिल्क का है, और उसके बाद नहीं, ये लाइन किसकी है, ये मैंने किसकी
लगाई.
सो अप टू दिस लिमिट हम इसको डिसाइड कर लेते हैं. अप टू दिस लिमिट मैं इसको डॉटेड लाइन में कंसीडर करता हूं. दिस इज द एरिया, अप टू दिस एरिया, फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर दिस एरिया इज आइडियल फॉर ग्रोइंग द
vegetables.
And beyond this, यह सबसे ऊपर वाली लाइन ये है ना, और इसको ऊपर ही. This is the second zone. This is ideal for rearing the milk cattle or the dairy farming. और उसके बाद ये वाला है ना, यहाँ से ये वाला. This is the limit for horticultural activity. And this is the limit beyond this, all this is up to here. This is the zone here, this is the zone for rearing the animals for meat purpose, livestock for meat purpose. So he identified near this city, but what about grain? Grains bhi to chahiye. But as per this calculation, this formula, in this area, we cannot cultivate grain. Grain is no more profitable. Grain to yahan koi fayde ki cheez nahi hai grow karne se, to grain kyun grow karenge? Sometimes we feel that farmers of Bihar are not growing food cash crops. They are growing only the food grain crops. For them, cash crop cultivation is like grain growing like this. Unka profit margin dusre crops mein jyada hai. So they are not. Same is, hum ye keh sakte hain, why the farmers of Maharashtra are not growing the food grain crop? They all are growing cash crops because their economic rent or the land rent or the profit margin is higher in this proportion. So basically, on the basis of this, we identified near the city, this is the according to economic rent, vegetable cultivation will give the highest profit. Then there should be the next zone of the milk, next zone should be for horticulture, next zone for the meat. So there are the zonation zones are given by the von Thunen, and subsequently to just simplify this, I would say this is suppose this is he gave one model. Suppose this is one river, this is the sea, and this is the city. This is the city, and this is one river or a one which gives the mode of transportation also. So, in city, mein sabse pehle zone kaun sa hoga? So he said this is the zone of the vegetables. Vegetables. Then second zone would be chota patla zone hoga. This is the zone of the milk production. Then the third zone is little bigger. This is the zone of horticultural activities. Horticultural activities. And further, this is the zone of the city. Se distance badhta hai to, see the nature of vegetable keep changes. This is the zone of the livestock for meat. Livestock for meat purpose. Yahan bhi livestock hai. But this livestock is for milk. This livestock is for meat. So, because these livestock require a vast pasture land, they stay. It can be transported according to the transport cost. It is good to rear such type of animal. So this is a kind of concentric zone model. Around the city we have the different circles of different crops. So as per this model, von Thunen says near the city we have more intensive farming. Vegetables are more intensive. Then the livestock, they require more intensive care. आजकल तो पशु ज्यादा बीमार पड़ते हैं इंसान से, बिकॉज एनिमल्स आर मोर प्रोन टू केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर. सब तो वो तो सब केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर का ही. एनिमल एंड मैन बोथ आर द पार्ट ऑफ द ग्रासलैंड फूड चेन. तो हम उनको जो जितना सब आप देखते हैं इन द मंथ ऑफ मे इन नॉर्थ इंडिया, एनिमल्स आर ईटिंग द ग्रीन फॉडर. अरे जून में मई में नॉर्थ इंडिया इज कंप्लीटली ड्राई, देयर इज नो वाटर, बट सब एनिमल्स को ग्रीन 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 मिल रहा है. इट इज द आउटकम ऑफ द फुल ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स. इनको इतना फर्टिलाइजर डाल डाल के हम उसको थोड़े से उसमें ग्रीन फॉडर ग्रो करते हैं. सो दैट लीड्स इंटेंस, उससे बीमार होंगे ना पशु, बट दैट रिक्वायर इंटेंसिफिकेशन. देन बियॉन्ड दिस हॉर्टिकल्चर रिक्वायर लेसर, और भी लेसर. Horticulture means we need different type of fruits and all, we require this is and the purpose is the intensity of cropping pattern changes, intensity change ho rahi hai, and the nature of crops are also changing, then we are going away from the city. So I hope you came to know the concept how the distance from the city influence the cropping pattern and the intensity and the entire agricultural system changes. It is developed by the Von Thun. But now question is whether Von Thunen is applicable today. In present, actually Von Thunen, he was a, you can say, that time period, it is perfect ideal farmer. उस जमाने में ट्रैक्टर नहीं होता था. उस जमाने में एनिमेट पावर वॉज द ओनली सोर्स ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड दिस इज द एक्सपेरिमेंट ही हैज डन इन द टेम्परेट क्लाइमेट वेयर ओनली वन और टू और थ्री क्रॉप्स कुड बी ग्रोन एंड ओनली वन इन ड्यूरिंग वन क्रॉप इन सीजन इन अ ईयर. सो ही हैड नो आइडिया अबाउट द इक्वेटोरियल क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशंस और ट्रॉपिकल क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशंस वेयर more than one crop can be grown in a year. So we have a three seasons, sometimes four crops in a year farmers are taking. So there are certain critics or the criticism of Von Thunen model. The first model of Von Thunen is that Von Thunen has given certain preconditions. And considering that these preconditions are everywhere applicable throughout the earth, which is not true, he developed an isotropic state or isotropic region where everything is equal. Nature of soil is same, nature of water supply is same, nature of fertility of the soil is same, the plain topography, but it is not. Like, so isotropic state is not possible on the earth. Earth is highly intricate and heterogeneous. It is the man who has to synchronize his needs according to the nature. This is one. Second, he said, man is a farmer, is enterprising farmer, and he changes his production, synchronize his production according to the demand of the market. But it is always not true, because agricultural sector population size is large and supply and demand have great fluctuation. We are interdependent, living in the interdependent world now. Akela, we are not self-centered ke hamari zarurat sirf yahi se puri hogi. You know, nowadays we are using a word, food mine. I don't know whether you have heard this word or not. Food mine. Food mine means the food, according to Von Thunen, what is the food mine? Ye kahan tak ka hai food mine? 15, 16, 20. कहाँ पैदा हुआ खाना? अगर सिटी में फूड आना है तो कहाँ से आएगा? 20, 30, 50 किलोमीटर से. But nowadays you are eating certain, like you consume the mango, say hapus mango. In there is a great demand of hapus mango in New York and the London and Tokyo and Melbourne. So what is the distance between Bombay? Hapus or the Alfonso is grown near Bombay. In Western Ghats, Western slope of Western Ghats, वहाँ से जाएगा तो food mile is 10,000 kilometer, 5,000 kilometer, 7,000 kilometer. You are eating several fruits. पता नहीं आजकल किसी शादी-वादी में जाते हैं रिसेप्शन वहाँ देखते हैं बहुत सारा फ्रूट का पंडाल लगा होता है. There are certain fruit you may not be knowing. They are not Indian. Last week I was eating one fruit called, I asked them what is the name of this fruit. Sharda. It's very delicious, full of sucrose. Sharda आपने सुना है? नहीं देखा है? Yes, it is there and it is found. It is the fruit of you can say it is the fruit of Australia, in southeastern part of Australia, from Queensland to New South Wales, and from the Great Dividing Range, the distance of that food is say 10,000 kilometer. That traveled from that region to Singapore and Singapore to India. That the shraddha which came in your fork, आपके चम्मच में जो आया है वो 10,000 किलोमीटर चल के आया है. That is food mile. The food you are eating, certain food you are eating the distance. पहले होता था ना, आज से almost before the WTO, the local people they were growing the local guava. यहाँ गांव में पास पास अमरूद का बाग है, उसमें उगाया और वहीं का एक इंसान वहां से सिर के ऊपर टोकरी रख के कहता अपने बाग से लेके आया. सो व्हाट वाज द फूड माइल? से 1 किलोमीटर, 2 किलोमीटर, 5 किलोमीटर, मैक्सिमम 10 किलोमीटर लोकल वहीं कंज्यूम हो जाता था. लोकल मैंगो वाज कंज्यूम्ड लोकली. अब द मैंगो इज अवेलेबल थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड. द सैरी, केसर, हापुस, चौसा, लंगड़ा, all are basically available in the market of New York. If you go to the market in New York, you will find चौसा. दशहरी from अलीहाबाद. It is written केसर from गुजरात. केसर is treated better because केसर has less perishability. You have been to गुजरात, आपने सब देखा, everywhere there are the mango horticultural activity was prominent. That is केसर mango. And केसर is equally tasty like हापुस. हापुस is perishable. हापुस बहुत जल्दी सड़ जाता है, खराब हो जाता है. It should be consumed at the earliest possible. केसर को कई महीने तक, 2 महीने तक उसको स्टोर में प्रिजर्व करके रखा जा सकता है. So केसर is, that's why because of its perishability it is treated better. So जिसकी perishability कम होगी that would be traded up to the more distance. That is food mile. उसका food mile बढ़ जाता है. केसर is available in every part of the world. So basically that is food mile sometimes. There are you may find in your plate. Let me tell you the present day almost there is the one FAO report that says out of the total production of food grains. Field to fork, खेत से चम्मच तक आने में, we waste almost 40% of the food. So कहीं transport में, कहीं terminal में, कभी storage में, कभी rodents में, कभी there are several problems are there. Foods are even destroyed because of the wrong storage capacity, storage conditions. So what happened? It reached only 60% of the total production. We should be so, but he ignored all these. One Thunen ignored all those factors that the world is changing. This world is going to be a one village. He was treating the city is one village, but now entire world is one village. So in that perspective, that model is not applicable. His preconditions like transport. Like one more, the production, farmers synchronize the production. Okay, India के farmer तो ऐसे हैं जैसे पिछ लगू होते हैं ना. India का farmer महाराष्ट्र में, ओ इस साल प्याज 100 रुपया किलो, तो जितने भी महाराष्ट्र के नासिक, मालेगांव और यू कैन से अहमदनगर और परभणी और नांदेड़ और जालना और उस्मानाबाद, सुलभ, नंदुरबार, जलगांव, कुछ भी, सब किसानों ने सब कुछ खत्म किया. इस पर प्याज 100 रुपया किलो बिका है तो सबने प्याज उगा दिया. क्या होगा अगले साल? बिकॉज दिस इज अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर एग्रीकल्चर. अगले साल प्याज है ना 10 रुपया, द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इज 20 रुपीज पर केजी, लेकिन वो मार्केट में 10 रुपया बिक रहा है बिकॉज सभी ने उगा दिया. सो इट मीन्स फार्मर कैन नॉट बी ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एंड एंटरप्राइजिंग 100% टू सिंक्रोनाइज हिज प्रोडक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द डिमांड ऑफ द मार्केट. So it is like farmer cannot be like on the other hand. चलो ये तो farmer ने पिछले साल का rate देख के इस बार grow किया. See if the farmer of say oranges, oranges are generally, which city is known for oranges?
Nagpur.
Nagpur में oranges, the price of the oranges are fluctuating like this. इस बार ऊपर फिर नीचे, फिर ऊपर फिर नीचे. Same is apples. Upar, niche. Number of trees are same. They cannot be replaced like onion. Pyaaz ki tarah usko nahi badal sakte. The paid hai, fixed hai. But unke bhi rate upar niche jaate hai. It means natural conditions, rain, temperature, snowfall, supply of the water to the field, I mean rain, soil moisture, climatic conditions, all natural conditions determine the production supply of the product, certain product. He ignored it. He said, no, it is the man who has to synchronize his, farmer who has to synchronize his production. So, यहाँ आप सेब है, अगर स्नोफॉल कश्मीर में अच्छा हो गया तो सेब आपको मिलेगा 40 रुपए किलो, और स्नोफॉल नहीं हुआ तो सेब मिलेगा 100 रुपए किलो. सो इट इज ऑल नेचुरल. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द नेचुरल कंडीशंस एंड वन स्टूडेंट इग्नोर्ड ऑल दोज नेचुरल कंडीशंस. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट ही सेड ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट. ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट इज लाइक he said transport cost, there is only one mode of transport and it increases with distance and weight. True, but we have the heterogeneous transport modes of transport now. We have the waterways, we have the railways, we have the roadways, we have the only three modes are there: रेलवेज, रोडवेज, वाटरवेज एंड एयरवेज. तो जल्दी पहुंचाना है एयरवेज. लाइक वी यूज टू से मैंगो शावर. मैंगो शावर टेक्स प्लेस इन तमिलनाडु एंड आंध्र प्रदेश. साइक्लोनिक टर्बुलेंस कम्स और अचानक साइक्लोनिक टर्बुलेंस में बहुत सारे कच्चे पक्के मैंगोज गिर जाते हैं. एंड मैंगो इज ए पेरिशेबल प्रोडक्ट. It should reach to the market at the earliest. तो market में तुरंत जाना चाहिए. So what happened? GT Express. Next day GT Express आएगी तो it is loaded with the mangoes. अगले दिन morning में आप देखेंगे कल तो एक भी ready पे mango नहीं बिक रहा था, आज तो सभी ready पे mango बिक रहे हैं. So it is. So we have the supply different type of mangoes. Immediately the change the supply pattern is there. So we have the different type of mode of transport. अलग अलग ट्रांसपोर्ट की जो मोड्स हैं एंड विद द इफ मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट आर डिफरेंट सो द रेट ऑफ द ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट विल वेरी. वो कम और ज्यादा हो जाता है. सो सर्टेन